for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called the sons of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted because of righteousness, for the kingdom of heaven is theirs. You are blessed when they insult you and persecute you and falsely say every kind of evil against you because of me. Be glad and rejoice, because your reward is great in heaven. For that is how they persecuted the prophets who went before you. My friends, know this, that we have all sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. Not one of us are perfect, no, not one. And we all are worthy and deserving of death. The Bible says that the wages of sin is death. Every wages of the things that we earn, what we earn is death and an eternal death in hell. But Jesus Christ came and he lived the perfect life that none of us could live. He died the death that we deserve. And he rose from the dead on the third day, justifying himself as the Son of God and justifying the people that the Father called before the foundation of the world. Know this, my friends, that we have all fallen short of the glory of God. We have all sinned. Every one of us are deserving of hell. But in the grace of God and his mercy, he has sent Jesus Christ to take the punishment of our sin, what we rightly deserve, if we will repent and trust in him. Notice, my friends, that God owes us nothing. He owes us nothing except death and eternal torment. But in his grace and mercy, he has sent his Son, the eternal Word of God, your Creator, and he commands you today to repent and to trust in him. Here in America, we constantly have the name of Jesus put in our ears. On every corner we can find a Bible. And my friends, do you pick up your Bible? Do you read it? Jesus said, man does not live by bread alone, but every word that proceeds from the mouth of God. Sustenance in the Word of God, my friends. Do you search for the world? Do you look for comfort in the world, in drugs, in alcohol, in sex, and in all sorts of vile things that the Lord hates? Notice, my friends, that even breathing without thanking God is sin, and as we walk through this world day by day, satisfying ourselves and satisfying the flesh, we are enemies of God. And Psalm 5:5 says that God hates the evil doer.
Amen.
The person doing the deed. He doesn't just send sin to hell. He sends the sinner to hell.
Amen.
And we don't want that for you, my friends. We want you to find forgiveness in Jesus Christ. That whosoever will repent of their sins and trust in the only name of the Son of God will find forgiveness for their sins.
Amen.
How you doing today, God? Thank you. Thank you.
No problem. God bless you guys. Be safe, guys.
But Jesus said, many will come to him on that day and will say, Lord, Lord, did we not prophesy in your name? Did we not do all these works in your name and cast out demons in your name? And he will say, away from me, you workers of iniquity, I never knew you.
Amen.
Because they're coming to him with their works. The prophet Isaiah says that all of our good works are filthy rags. And that word in the Hebrew, filthy rags, is translated from a word that means bloody menstrual rags, a bloody tampon. If you think you're going to get to heaven and offer God your good works, you might as well give him a bloody maxi pad. That's how he sees it. My friends, we are not good. No, not one is good. We have all fallen short of the glory of God.
Amen.
I am the chief of sinners. I can guarantee you I've sinned as much as any of you.
Amen.
I am no better than anyone, but I am better off, because I'm looking to Christ alone for my righteousness. My friends, we cannot please God. God can only please himself.
Amen.
And in his grace and mercy, he has sent Jesus Christ. God bless you, all right?
No problem.
God bless you, man. We love you. Anything for you, man, please let me know. That's why we're here.
Have a good day, brother.
And we love you. That's why we're here. We're not here to tell anyone. We don't take pleasure in telling people they're on their way to hell. But true love warns, my friends.
Amen.
True love warns when someone's in trouble. If you see a blind man walking towards a cliff, you're not going to pat him on the back and say, my friend, keep walking, it's good for you. No, you're going to scream, turn around, you're heading towards your death. And proverbially, that's what we're doing today. We're saying you're spiritually blind. The Bible speaks of people who have eyes to see,
but they cannot see. They have ears to hear, but they cannot hear. Hear the word of the Lord today and know that even repentance is a gift. If you have found that Jesus Christ is a perfect Savior and you have repented of your sins, you can know that it is the Lord Jesus Christ alone, and His work alone, to His glory alone, by His scripture alone, that you will find salvation. And if you refuse to repent of your sin and refuse to bow your knee today, know this, my friends, that there will come a day that every knee will bow and every tongue will confess that Jesus Christ is Lord.
Amen.
And we want to encourage you today, my friends, to bow your knee and confess today of your own accord. And don't wait until God's hand shoves you down by your head to your knees and then eventually casts you into hell. We don't want that for you, my friends. We love you. That's why we're here. We have been shown the grace of Jesus Christ. We have been shown the love of God in Christ. We've been forgiven for our sins. How can we have such a glorious truth and not share it with you? How can you say you love someone and not give them the medicine for their illness?
Amen.
The only medicine, the only cure for sin is Jesus Christ. He's the only way that we will find ourselves to be made right with God. Amen. Not on your own works. The Pope can't save you. Christ is risen. He is alive, justifying himself as God and justifying his people as forgiven. And if you today will bow your knee to Christ and repent of your sin, then you will find him to be a perfect Savior.
Amen.
He will turn away none who come to him with a heart of repentance. If you can admit that God's law is right and your ways are wrong, and we must submit to him, that's the beginning. Fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. Jesus said, fear not him who can kill the body, but fear him who can kill the body and the soul by sending it to hell. And only God alone can do that, my friends. I'm not here to be your judge. I can judge no one. But I'm here to warn of the judgment to come.
Amen.
That there will come a day that we will all answer for our sins. There will come a day that every idle word that you spoke will be called to account. That every thought that you've thunk will be called to account, that every action you perform will be called to account. And know this, that even in our best works, even my best works are stained by sin. Even my best works must be filtered through the blood of Jesus Christ, because
Amen.
I can offer nothing to a holy God.
Amen.
God opposes the proud, but gives grace to the humble.
Amen.
Will you humble yourselves today, my friends, before a holy God? Every one of us will die. We are part of that ultimate statistic. 10 out of 10 of us will die. And when that day comes and we're called to account for the way that we lived, you must know that there will be no one next to you when you meet God. When you come before your Maker to answer for your sins, no one will be there. It will be you alone, naked and ashamed before God and His holy angels. And the Bible says that sin is a wretched stench in the nostrils of God. Christ was a pleasant and fragrant aroma to God's nostrils. My friends, will you hide in Christ? Will you look to Christ and hide in Him to find salvation? Or will you face the wrath of God on your own and be embarrassed before God and the holy angels? My friends, we don't want it for you. We want you to repent. We want you to taste life. Jesus Christ came to give life and give it to the abundance, and that is not a cheap promise of worldly goods. Jesus Christ came to forgive us of our sins, to lead us to repentance and faith. And if we refuse to repent of our sins, there will come a day of reckoning. Hide in Christ, my friends. Sir, do you know Christ? God bless you, sir. Do you know Christ today, my friends? A lot of people claim to know Christ, but what they know is an idol. Do you know that an idol is not always a piece of wood or stone that you bow to? But an idol is anything that you fashion in your mind that you call God that is not God. We've all been guilty of adultery. We put things in the place of God that are not God. We make up in our minds a God to suit ourselves, who loves the thing that we love and hates the things that we hate. But guess what? God is who He is. God said to Moses, I am who I am. Jesus said, before Abraham was, I am. Jesus is the great I am.
Amen.
Only by the blood of Christ will you find reconciliation with the Father. Only by the blood of Christ will you find your sins to be forgiven. And my friends, you will find Him to be a perfect Savior. He who the Son sets free is free indeed.
Amen.
Set your chains of bondage down, my friends. Call to Christ to break these chains of bondage, of addiction, of sexual sin, of lust, the lust of the eyes and the flesh, the love of the world. Jesus said, pick up your cross and follow me. The cross is a torture device, my friends. The cross is not a comfortable thing. We are called to crucify our flesh. The purpose of life is not enjoyment. The purpose of life is not our comfort. The purpose of life is to be conformed to the image of Jesus Christ. And if we are sinners or so far from the glory of Jesus Christ, what will it take to conform us to that image, my friends? The prophet Isaiah said that he is a man of sorrows. How can we become a man of sorrows if we're not acquainted with sorrow ourselves? God will use evil things for our sanctification to bring us closer to God. Like I said, the purpose of life is to be conformed to the image of God, to be conformed to the image of His Son. As a sinful man, I am far from Christ. Even today, I'm not the man I once was, but I'm not also the man who I should be. Jesus Christ is the foundation. Jesus Christ is the status quo of what a Christian looks like, and none of us meet that mark. And thank God for the blood of Christ.
Amen.
Because we don't meet that mark, and we can bathe ourselves in the blood of Christ by His Holy Spirit and be forgiven for our sins. But my friends, there's a condition. You must repent. You must repent. You must hate the stain even on your brother's garment of sin. The reason there is so much hostility and hatred in the world is because of sin. The reason there is disease in the world is because of sin, addiction because of sin. But the Lord Jesus Christ came to give life and give it to the abundance. Like I said, this is not a promise of material wealth, of health, wealth, and prosperity, but this is a promise of forgiveness of sins. My friends, do you see your sins as red as crimson? Because Jesus Christ can make them white as snow. The Bible says that He will cast your sin as far as the east is from the west. But you must repent and trust in Him. There is no other way. There is no other way to God. You can't make the road yourself. Muhammad can't save you. He is dead and he was a false prophet. Buddha can't save you. He's dead. Mary can't save you. She is in the glory of God right now, worshiping her Savior. As she said, my soul magnifies in my Savior. Why would Mary need to say that if she was sinless? She can't save you. My friends, Jesus Christ is the only way. Look to Christ and live. If you look to Christ, He will change your heart. Those things that you once loved, you will start to hate. The things that you once hated, you will start to love. He will do an open heart surgery, and He will take the hardness of the heart out and make it flesh. But my friends, you must humble yourselves and repent.
Amen.
There is no other way. God does not leave it up to you to choose how to get to heaven. There is only one way. We are all deserving of hell. But because of Christ, we have been made a way to get to heaven. God bless you, sir. Repent of your sins, my friends. We're here because we love you for no other reason. Because we love you. Because we love Jesus. And He's commanded us to come out and proclaim His good news. But know this, that if you hear this message and you reject this message today, all you're doing is stoking the pits of hell for yourself and making it hotter. For he who's been given much, much is required. When you have the gospel put before your face and you reject it, my friends, you don't reject me, you reject Jesus Christ. And if you reject Jesus Christ, you reject the only way to be made right with the Father. There is no way for us to be made right, my friends, without Christ. Look to Christ and live, my friend.
Amen.
We love you, my friends. We're here for no other reason but we love you. Come to Christ. Look to Christ and live. You will find Him to be a perfect Savior. I know your hearts now are thinking, but if I come to Christ, I have to stop doing these things that I love. But step out in faith and believe the promise of God that the Holy Spirit of God will do an open heart surgery on you, that He will make you love the things that God loves. Jesus said, my yoke is easy and my burden is light. It would be a heavy burden if I had to follow the laws of God on my own and do it on my own. But that's not the case. Jesus Christ followed that law perfectly for me, so that his perfect righteousness could be placed on my account through faith alone. And not only that, but my sin was placed on his cross. It's called the Great Exchange, my friends. He took my sin and gave me his righteousness. Amen. And when that happens, the Holy Spirit changes your heart and you will notice a change in your life.
Amen.
Paul says, shall we go on sinning so that grace may abound? May it never be. How can we who have been crucified to sin continue to live in it? When you realize what your sin has done, that your sin is what pinned the Lord Jesus Christ to that tree, you will feel a guilt, and you will know, I can't keep living in this. Do you know that you, that your sin, if Christ died for you, that you are that Roman centurion that nailed those nails in his wrists and his feet? You are the one who put that crown of thorns in his head, spit on his face, and pulled out his beard. And when you continue to sin after knowing about that sacrifice, it's like you're hammering the nails into his wrist and laughing at his face, saying, you're going to forgive me again? Are you going to forgive me again? My friends, you will not be forgiven because you tread and you trample on the blood of Christ. The truly regenerate person sees their sin for what it is, wickedness, and they turn from it. Now, I'm not preaching a moralism saying that you will be perfect if you're a Christian, because you won't. I sin every day. But the mark of a Christian is not perfection, but it is repentance. Do you see your sin for what it is, and do you turn from it? And is there a battle going on in your heart? Or do you just give in every time? My friends, I want to encourage you, Paul, the apostle said, to examine yourself to see if you're in the faith. Do you love the brethren? Do you have a desire to be with Christians? When you read the Bible and come across a hard passage, do you get under that and say, well, the word of God is true, let every man be a liar? Or do you try to eisegete that passage and make it say what you want it to say? Do you repent of your sins and trust in Christ? Or are you just putting Jesus Christ on as fire insurance? My friends, look to Christ and live.
Amen.
If you have any questions, we will be here to talk. We love you.
Amen. Word.